Welcome to my channel, and today I will be explaining you the summary of the chess written by French-Romanian playwright Eugene Ionesco, and it was first published in 1952. So talking about the characters, this play mainly has two characters, or the protagonist is the old man and the old woman. So the old man is 95 years old and the old woman is 94 year old. So they've been married for 75 years. And they live on an island. So they live away from the rest of the world in a tower on a deserted island. So old man is about 95 and the old woman is about 94 years. So their conversations are meaningless, monotonous, but they give us an insight into their life by letting us know they've been through a lot. Their life was filled with disappointments and failure, and they missed out on many opportunities, so they never had the chance to reach the success they were longing for. Now, on the mere end of their lives, they regret everything. All of a sudden, a change occurs in their lives. Old man decides it's time to invite certain people to the island and let them know some information that could change the humankind. While they are setting the chairs, they hear a boat coming. The guests are invisible and only the old man and the woman can see them. They act as if all of the guests were real and visible to everyone. They even talk to them and show them their seats and serve food and drinks for them. The couple is unaware of the fact that they are serving air and that the whole gathering was taking place only in their head. As the guests leave, they place the chairs onto the stage. Billy and her husband, these are the invisible guests, Lady and Colonel and many others like the newspaper man and other guests. Okay, so arrive, but the scene is still empty. There are no people, but the chairs keep on piling up and no one is sitting on them. The couple keeps on placing chairs to the scene until it's fully covered with them. Soon there was a crowd of invisible people and the couple got lost in their mass because they don't know the crowd. They know the lady, and they know his husband, who is like photo engraver. So both of them are like the old woman, like old man's friend, but they know lady, they know colonel, they know newspaper man and other guests, but they don't know the other guest who arrives after like the ballet and his husband photo engraver. So they just lost their mind and they just start yelling at each other because they was not able to, because of the noise, you know, they were not able to hear each other. So then the imaginary emperor arrives. Old man persistently wants to see the emperor, but he can't because of the invisible crowd. Old man and old woman then shout out, "Long live the emperor," and then they jump into the sea and die. Orator comes to the stage and stand still. He is dressed to look unreal in comparison to the invisible guest. And one more thing, that this orator, who is not invisible, he is actually visible, and he looks like a 19th century artist, like well dressed, like an old man, like he is about 45 to 50 years of age, and he looks like a 19th century artist. So he has his duty, which is to let the invisible guest know the information on how to save the humanity. And This duty was given by the old man to convey his message, so that the orator can convey the old man's message. So with his duty, the necessity of the old couple existence no longer exists. The invisible scene waits for orator to talk, but he finally wants to pronounce something. He realizes he is voiceless. Actually, he is deaf and dumb, so he is not able to say utter a single word. The author emphasized even more the absurdity of the orator. Orator wrote some words on the board since he is not able to utter some words, as he is deaf and dumb and mute also. So on the board that made no sense. So orator wrote some of the words on the board that made no sense, and then he turned to the audience. When he realized no one understood his message, he decided to leave the stage in fury. So the audience sits quietly, the chairs are on the scene, the window is open, and the couple is dead. Orator went away and the emptiness is all around. Everything is quiet. All of a sudden some voices are heard, but there is no one. The author wanted to make an impression on the audience and carve the last moment into their memory. The curtains closes. So actually the old woman and the old man both commit suicide. So this suggests that some people would prefer death to living with the illusion shattered by reality. I hope you've understood this summary. If you find the video helpful, please subscribe to my channel and please like to the video. Thank you.